Hello friends, welcome back. In this particular video, we will be starting the experimental part. So in our pharmaceutical analysis lab 3, we have one experiment based on the chromatographic technique, which is very widely used in the research laboratories, that is to identify the given sample by TLC. So what is aim of experiment? To identify the given sample by thin layer chromatography. So the requirements for the experiment are, we need to have standard aspirin and paracetamol. We need to have the solvents like methanol for dissolving the sample as well as the standard drugs. We need to have chloroform, toluene, acetone and glycylacetic acid, because they are the mobile phase or the solvents used for the solvent system. Then we need to have a developing chamber if commercially made available, or you can use simple small beaker with petri plate as a glass lid. Then you need to have the pipettes, then pre-coated TLC plate, UV cabinet to observe the spots after elution, and you need to have the scale and pencil. Now, what is the principle behind this particular experiment? As we know, the thin layer chromatography is one of the planar chromatographic technique. So our stationary phase is arranged in a planar arrangement, and this stationary phase, which is usually the silica gel, this silica gel is coated on a support of alumina sheets. Now these alumina sheets acts as a supporting material, and the silica gel, which is mixed with gypsum, that is a binder, and it has a fluorescent material at the short wavelength. So this is coated in a very fine thin manner uniformly on the alumina sheets, and the thickness of this particular layer is usually 0.25 mm. So here the silica gel is acting as a stationary phase, and as we know, silica gel is a polar in nature. So here the stationary phase is polar, therefore we need to use the mobile phase complementary to that. So the mobile phase nature will be relatively non-polar. So we know when we have the polar stationary phase and non-polar mobile phase, this particular combination is known as normal phase chromatography. So this is a normal phase chromatography, and we are separating our compounds or the drugs based on the affinity towards the stationary phase and the mobile phase. So this is basically solid liquid chromatography, because here the nature of the stationary phase is solid, which is nothing but a silica, and the mobile phase we are using, that is a combination of four different solvents which are liquid in nature. So therefore it is solid liquid chromatography, and whenever we have a solid liquid chromatography, the mechanism of separation is based on the adsorption affinity. Okay, so based on the adsorption affinity of each solute or the analyte, it will migrate on a particular surface of the stationary phase with the help of mobile phase, and the separation is happen. Okay, now after separation, most of the times the compounds are not visible to our eye. So we need to use some visualizing agent or the detecting methods, which could be a chemical methods or which could be a physical methods. Okay, so this is basically the principle of this particular experiment. Now this experiment involves a series of steps. So first step is usually the preparation of the mobile phase. So to minimize the time, first we need to prepare the mobile phase. We have to pipette out the required amount of each solvent in a developing chamber or a beaker in an accurate way, and we have to saturate the chamber. So chamber saturation is very much important to migrate the solvent system in a uniform way throughout the stationary phase. Okay, now once you saturate the chamber, which is usually take 10 to 20 minutes, and you can fasten up by putting a filter paper. Then next is the sample preparation. So usually the sample is prepared because we most of the times have sample in the solid form. So sample need to be dissolved in a appropriate solvent, usually a volatile solvent, which can evaporate after spotting of particular sample, then we need to activate the plates. So activation of plate is nothing but removal of moisture which is adsorbed on the surface of the stationary phase. So often during handling of plates, the plates come into atmospheric moisture, and if atmospheric moisture is present during the elution, it will have the effect on RF value as well as it will have effect on the separation speed. After activation of plate, usually you have to activate the plate, just you cut the plate as per your need, and then you have to keep this plate in a beaker and put this beaker in an oven at 110 degrees Celsius for usually 1 hour. So by that time the moisture adsorbed will be evaporate and you can use the plates which are activated plates. Then you need to spot the sample with the capillary for a qualitative analysis. Then you need to develop the plate. So developing plate is nothing but the migrating or eluting your solvent along with the solute molecules towards the solvent front. So solvent front reaches approximately 80 to 90% of the total plate height. Then your development of plate is done. You can take out the plate. The moment you take out the plate, you have to mark the solvent front, and then you have to keep the plates in an oven for drying. Once you dry the plate, then you can spray the spraying agents, or you can dip the plate in a chemical reagent, or usually we observe the plates under the UV light in a UV cabinet, and then we detect the spot. We can mark the spot with the help of pencil, and we can measure the RF value with the scale, and then we can compare the RF value of our unknown sample with that of the reference standard. So these are the experimental steps. Now in this particular experiment, the mobile phase or the solvent system what we are using is a combination of four solvents, that is the chloroform, toluene, acetone, glycyl acetic acid. So this is in a volume of 6.5, 1, 2.5 and 0.1 ml. So what is expected result in this particular experiment is, you have to report these things: RF value of standards, number of compounds in the given samples you identified, then what is RF value of your given unknown sample, and identify the sample with the justification. So whether your sample is particular A or B, or if it is given the name of the drug, that you have to reveal, and you have to comment on the polarity of the sample or the standard spots with proper justification. So these are the experimental setup you need to use. So in this particular experiment, so this is the apparatus. So first step is we need to prepare the mobile phase. So in this case, the mobile phase is mixture of chloroform, then toluene, acetone, and this is glycyl acetic acid. So we have kept dedicated pipettes for the solvents, and this is our developing chamber. So we are using simple beaker of 100 ml capacity, and this is our cover. So this is a petri plate. Then we are doing pipetting with the rubber bulb, and for removing and keeping the plate we need to have the forceps, and these are the capillaries which we are using for spotting our sample. Now we have different samples which are prepared here. So we have diclofenac sodium, then we have aspirin, and then we have paracetamol. Now as this experiment is the TLC experiment, so we have these pre-coated ready-made plates. So these are manufactured by the company Merck, and this is used for analytical chromatography. So we have discussed in the theory, analytical chromatography is the chromatography used for identification. So these are the TLC plate which has the adsorbent, that is silica gel, and the mesh size is 60. So the adsorbent layer which is coated on the alumina support, that has the silica mesh size 60, and it is have the fluorescent material which can be observed at 254 nanometer, that is under the short UV length. So this is TLC silica gel 60F 254,
and this particular box usually contain 25 silica sheets. So this is one entire sheet. So usually the silica comes in a size of 20 by 20 centimeter, and we can see this is a alumina support, and on the alumina support other side we have the silica which is coated on this particular supporting material, and we can see horizontally the silica gel is coated in a very fine way, and the thickness of the silica over the surface of alumina is 0.25 mm. Okay, so we have seen the thinner the adsorbent layer, faster will be the separation on the chromatographic plate. So as such, we don't require this much size of plate for identifying one or two component in a particular plate. So we can customize these plates by cutting with the knife or the scissor as per our requirement. So we can cut the plates according to this particular size. So we can spot here three particular sample or standard substances. Oscar. Now we are preparing the solvent system or the mobile phase. So first we are going to take or pipette out the chloroform. Now the volume of chloroform required in this particular separation is 6.5 ml. So we have to adjust the level at zero. Now I will be pipetting out 6.5 ml of the solvent. Okay, so we have pipetted out 6.5 ml, and then immediately you have to close the lid and then drain the remaining solvent. You can close this particular lid because it is volatile. Now the next is the toluene. Now toluene amount is 2.5 ml, sorry, it is 1 ml. Now we need to pipette out 1 ml of toluene. So 1 ml of toluene has been pipetted out. Now next is acetone. Now the volume of acetone is 2.5 ml. So I have taken acetone and we need to pipette out 2.5 ml of acetone. So we have pipetted out 2.5 ml of acetone. Now the last is acetic acid. So acetic acid is 0.1 ml. So if you are capable to take 0.1 ml, you can take it, otherwise you can add just one drop of acetic acid. So this is added 2 drops of acetic acid. Now this is how we have prepared the solvent system. So we can shake the beaker, and now we have to keep this beaker aside for at least 10 minutes activated. Now we are taking the scale and pencil, and with the help of pencil we are going to draw the starting line or the baseline. So usually we have to measure the distance roughly about 1.5 or 1 centimeter, and with the gentle hand we can draw the baseline. Now while drawing the baseline, we have to see to that the silica layer will not get disturbed, and as we are going to spot here one sample and two reference standard, so we can mark at what point we are going to spot our standards and samples. So these are the three spots. So here I am going to spot my first reference, second reference and my sample. So this is how we can draw the baseline and we can spot the points on which we are going to spot our sample. Now we have to prepare the capillary for spotting our sample, because the capillary should be pointed and these are the simple capillaries. So we can gently heat these capillaries on the flame, and on both the hands we can pull these capillaries. So we can prepare 3-4 capillaries. Now we are applying our sample on the TLC plate. So we have prepared these capillaries and these are the standard. So one is, this one is aspirin, which I have taken in this fusion tube. The other one is a paracetamol. So this is taken in the second fusion tube. And the third one is our sample. Okay, so we have to identify in this sample which drug is present, whether it is aspirin or whether it is a paracetamol. So these are the two reference compounds or the standards what we have. So first I am taking the aspirin. Now initially you can just spot on the rough paper and see or ensure the capillary is prepared very well. Now the first dot where we have marked, we are going to spot our first standard drug. So by this way we can spot our sample or the standard. Now second, I am using another separate capillary. Again I will check and this is fine. So I am going to spot the second, that is paracetamol. Now the third is my sample. So again for sample we will see and we will spot the sample. Sample spotting is done. So we can keep this plate inside the developing chamber. Now by this time the chamber is saturated. Now we can take this plate and we can put inside this particular developing chamber. Now we are going to spot our samples. So this is a TLC plate where we have marked the spots where we are going to spot our reference and sample. So this is, first is a aspirin standard which I have spotted here. I am using a separate capillary for next standard, that is a paracetamol, which I am going to spot here. So this is a paracetamol, and the third is my unknown sample which I am going to find out with this TLC, but I am going to spot it here. Okay, so sample spotting is done. Now we have to evaporate the solvent, which will evaporate within a minute. So here we can see the solvent system is migrating over the surface of the stationary phase, and we have to allow the solvent system to migrate at least 80% or 2/3 of the total distance from the bottom line. So once it reaches 75% or 80% of the total height, then we will take out the plate and we have to mark the solvent front. Now the solvent front has reached, so with the forceps we can take out the plate and immediately we have to mark the solvent front. So we can mark the edges and then we can put the solvent front line this way. So you can see here, this is a solvent front and this has migrated uniformly because we have saturated the chamber and this is the baseline. Okay, so now we can keep this plate inside the oven so that the solvent will evaporate and then we will observe under the UV chamber. So this is our UV cabinet. So we have here three operating knobs, one operating at short UV, that is 254 nanometer, other one operating at long UV, that is at 365 nanometer, and the third one is the visible light. So we have put our plates in this particular cabinet. So this is our plate what we have developed and evaporated in the oven, and then we can close this lid and we can switch on this particular knob. Now we can observe under the UV light, there are total three spots observing in this particular plate. Now with the long pencil, we have to circle these spots. Okay, so I will be circling these spots with the pencil. So this is the first spot, this is the second spot, and this is the third spot. Okay,
now next is the calculation. So once we have identified and detected the spot, the spots are marked like this. So we have to mark the center of the spot also, and then we have to measure the distance by putting a vertical line from center of the spot towards the baseline in this particular way, and then we can measure the distance in centimeter. And similarly, we have to measure the distance by drawing a vertical line from solvent front towards the baseline or the starting line. So we have to calculate the RF value. So RF value is nothing but a retardation factor, and this factor is nothing but a ratio of distance traveled by solute divided by distance traveled by the solvent. Now in standard A, which has been spotted in the first from the left side, so that is having a distance of 1 centimeter divided by distance of solvent front, that is 5.5. So the ratio is 0.18. similarly for standard B, which is the second spot here, that is having 2.2 centimeter distance divided by solvent front distance, so it is 0.4. and then our unknown sample which was spotted in the last, that one, the third one, so it is having 2.2 distance divided by 5.5, so it is coming around 0.4. so 0.4, which is the RF value of sample, is matching with the RF value of standard B. So we can make out this spots are migrated at same distance, so it could be same. So we have to report the result. Now while reporting the result, first we have to mention the RF value of the standards. So we have used two standards, standard A and standard B, so that RF value we can write here. Then how many number of compounds we found in a given sample. So as we could make out in our sample spot, there was only one spot which have been separated, so we can write it here 1. Then we have to report the RF value of sample, that is 0.4, and with these we can identify the sample with justification. So we can write the given unknown sample is B as its RF value is matching with the RF value of standard B. Now we also should write the comment on polarity of sample spot or the spots based on what sample is given. If you may have be given with the mixture of the two, that is A and B, or it could be either A or B. So you have to write a proper justification on the polarity. Okay, so we can make out standard A has traveled less compared to standard B or compound B. So we can say standard A is more polar than standard B. So this is a comment on the polarity. Now why standard A is more polar than standard B, we have to write the justification. So we can write as this is a normal phase chromatography where the stationary phase is polar and the mobile phase is non-polar. It elutes non-polar compound faster than the polar compounds. Therefore, standard A will have high affinity or stronger interaction with that of the stationary phase, which is polar in nature. And on the other hand, standard B will have lesser affinity towards the stationary phase. That is higher affinity towards the mobile phase. Thank you.